We're going live now. Good afternoon. Welcome to the St. Hilda's Fairbank Noonday Bite and Sip. My name is Pauline Bourne, and with me today is our priest in charge, Father Canute Francis. Call to worship. In the beginning, before time, before people, before the world began,
God was.
Here and now among us, beside us, enlisting the people of earth for the purpose of heaven.
God is.
In the future, when we have turned to dust and all we know has found its fulfillment.
God will be.
Not denying the world, but delighting in it. Not condemning the world, but redeeming it through Jesus Christ. By the power of the Holy Spirit.
God was, God is, God will be.
Our opening prayer, let us pray. Lord, our God, where is there another God like you? A God of justice and unfailing love, who stands by every promise made to his people, generation after generation. There's no other, you alone are God. And so we gather together to worship you, to give you thanks, to proclaim your greatness, to sing your praise, to seek your face, and to celebrate your faithful presence with us. We pray that your spirit would guide and inspire our worship. Open our mouth to sing and speak your praise. Open our ears to hear your word. Open our eyes to see you at work among us. Open our hearts to receive your love. We offer ourselves to you in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
Our psalm for today is Psalm 121. I lift up my eyes to the hills, from where will my help come?
My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth.
He will not let your foot be moved. He who keeps you will not slumber.
He who keeps Israel will neither slumber nor sleep.
The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade at your right hand.
The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night.
The Lord will keep you from all evil. He will keep your life.
The Lord will keep your going out and your coming in from this time on and forevermore.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
The scripture reading is from Luke chapter 7, verses 1 to 17. A reading from the Gospel according to Luke. After Jesus had finished all his sayings in the hearing of the people, he entered Capernaum. A centurion there had a slave whom he valued highly and who was ill and close to death. When he heard about Jesus, he sent some Jewish elders to him, asking him to come and heal his slave. When they came to Jesus, they appealed to him earnestly, saying, "He is worthy of having you do this for him, for he loves our people. And it is he who built our synagogue for us." Jesus went with them, but when he was not far from the house, the centurion sent friends to him to say, "Lord, do not trouble yourself, for I am not worthy to have you come under my roof. Therefore, I did not presume to come to you, but only speak the word, and let my servant be healed. For I also am a man set under authority, the soldiers under me. And I say to one, 'Go,' and he goes, and to another, 'Come,' and he comes, and to my slave, 'Do this,' and the slave does it." When Jesus heard this, he was amazed at him. And turning to the crowd that followed him, he said, "I tell you, not even in Israel have I found such faith." When those who had been sent returned to the house, they found the slave in good health. Soon afterward, he went to a town called Nain, and his disciples and a large crowd went with him. As he approached the gate of the town, a man who had died was being carried out. He was his mother's only son, and she was a widow. And with her was a large crowd from the town. When the Lord saw her, he had compassion for her and said to her, "Do not weep." Then he came forward and touched the bear. And the bear stood still. And he said, "Young man, I say to you, rise." The dead man sat up and began to speak. And Jesus gave him to his mother. Pharisees, all of them, and they glorified God, saying, "A great prophet has risen among us, and God has looked favorably on his people." This word about him spread throughout Judea and all the surrounding country. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. Blessed Savior, at this hour you hung upon the cross, stretching out your loving arms. Grant that all mankind may look to you and be saved, who lives and reigns with the Father and the Holy Spirit, ever one God, world without end.
Amen. Psalm 121. And I particularly want to focus on these verses. "I look to the hills from whence cometh my help. My help comes from the Lord, who makes heaven and earth." In September, one of my friends called me in the middle of the night. And the one word that was uttered about 10 times was help. Help, help, help. And she goes on. She said, "Help, I can't do this any longer." Another September night in my neighborhood, we were on the outside and my neighbor came out running. He heard someone screaming for help. When the person was found, she didn't know where she was and what had happened to her. He came to her rescue. Sometimes we do feel helpless. And more than that, we all need help. We all need help on this journey of life. Psalm 121 is a stark reminder that God is our help. God is our keeper. God is our protection, our shade, and our deliverer. This is so fitting in this moment and days of great uncertainty. We need to hear that over and over again. God is our help. It is generally accepted that Psalm 121 was written for those who were making their way to Jerusalem for the Passover and for the Pentecost celebrations. The journey is one that can be met with danger, exhaustion, loneliness, and a fear of the unknown. But the writer assures us that God protects and keeps. He keeps us from slipping. He keeps us in the dark. He keeps us from danger and from evil. He calls us to look to God. When the answer we seek is far from coming, when the strain and stress of life overwhelm us, when trouble is near, when we feel we can't make it or we can't take it any longer, we cry for help, but we should cry to God. The psalmist says, "I look to God from where my help is to come." This beautiful hymn of trust is about the sure knowledge that when we are in trouble, We need only look to the Lord for strength, for guidance, for wisdom, for power, and for help. In the gospel reading, we see the centurion crying out to Jesus for help. Come and heal my slave. As a matter of fact, he said, do not bother to come, just speak, because I'm not worthy. But he saw in Jesus his helper. The widow whose son died, Jesus came to her rescue. He helped her in a moment of distress and sorrow. The psalmist says, I look to God from where my help is to come. We can take comfort in the majesty of God, in the power of God, in the help of God. For if God made heaven and earth, God can certainly help us in our times of need. And we all need help. Think on these things. Amen.
Okay, we'll now have the intercession. Let us pray. Lord God, maker of heaven and earth, you made magnificent mountains and the oceans, the tiny worms and bugs, and everything in between. And you made us. You are amazing and powerful, yet you love each of us dearly. Thank you for guiding our lives and ruling all of creation. In the knowledge of your love and your power, we bring before you our praise for our world. Lord, we look to you.
Our help comes from you.
Lord of hosts, guide the leaders of our world and give your wisdom to all who are making decisions. Send your peace on earth. Purge your earth of this virus that plagues us. Heal all who are affected and bless all who work on the front line. Lord, we look to you.
Our help comes from you.
Gracious God, may our Christian friends throughout the world feel your power and strength. Bring an end to the fighting among believers and the persecution of believers by unbelievers. Give our missionaries courage and passion. Lord, we look to you.
Our help comes from you.
God of passion, bless us and those we love with safety, health, endurance. Bring comfort and strength to the lonely, the depressed, the despondent, and the fearful. Lord, we look to you.
Our help comes from you.
Our help comes from you, the maker of heaven and earth. For you watch over us day and night, and you have provided for all we need. We pray through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
And as our Savior has taught us, let us pray. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Our encounter with Jesus. Draw me today into fresh encounters with Jesus, O God. Make me a servant of love, so that others may know how much you love them, and I may know how much you love me. Let me not be afraid of new pastures, whether they be green or brown or parched. As I pass through the day's valleys, keep my head lifted up to the mountain, from whence my help comes. Never let me forget the people Jesus welcomed, the greedy and the great, the bad and the good, the respected and the cheats. Even as the world becomes more callous and chaotic, May I never underestimate your capacity to fashion the miraculous from the monstrous, even to make me a choice masterpiece from the mire and the clay. Creator God, draw me in a fresh encounter with Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. Liberating God, we seek your journey. With parted waters, set us free. With cloud and fire, guide us. With gushing waters, quench our thirst. With food from heaven, feed us. Draw us out with joy and singing, that we might know your ways, and bless us this day and always.
Amen.
Okay, announcements. Our noonday bite and sip are held every Tuesday and Thursday at 12 noon. Sunday services are at 8:30 and 10:30 a.m. And for those services, you'll need to register in advance. Please know also that the 10:30 service will be live streamed on YouTube. Our online Sunday school program, Kids for Jesus, is held every Sunday at 12 noon. You also have Holy Eucharist on Wednesdays at 10:30 a.m. And our next Bible study will be held on October 26th at 7 p.m. We'd like to thank Martin de Groot for the music that we play today, and also liturgical resources were from the Ministry Matters, Leonard Sweet, Calvin Institute, A Week Work, Shop Boat, and Joanna Harder. Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Be blessed and be a blessing to others.